Hello and welcome everyone, and this is the last video of the JS interview question series. I will be adding more in the future about the JS interview questions, so you can crack the JavaScript interview questions easily. So let's go through this last video. What is a prototypical inheritance, which is the most basic questions in JavaScript? So in prototypical inheritance, we are creating a functions and we keeps adding the prototype functions like this. Rectangle.prototype parameter is one of the method I added, right? Now whenever you are creating an object of this functions, each and every object will have this parameter functions added, right? So prototype functions are those functions which are not copied for each and every object. They are actually in the shared instance, so each and every object can access those prototype methods, and these prototype methods can also be copied or can also be inherited by another function if that function is inheriting the function prototype. Okay, what is a self property? Okay, this is just the workaround which we are doing in the ES5 to provide this scope inside a nested function. So if you see out function is a function, and inside that I am having set timeout function. So this object is available till now, right? If I wanted to access this object inside another function, then I need to assign this object to some variable and then I can access that property. Okay. What is a prototype chain? Is like a prototype chain and proto chain. When we try to access any property, first it checks property owned by the object or not. If that property doesn't exist there, it is checking the prototype and so on. So it is actually checking to the prototype chain at the upper level. Then if it is not there, then it will check the prototype of that object. So this chain go on. Gradually it moves up in the prototype chain until it reaches to the object.prototype. Object is capital object.prototype, which is object function. So this prototype chain starts from the functions and it reaches to the parent one, which is object.prototype, which is actually the root one in the JavaScript object. Okay. Global local scope, whatever is defined inside a function is actually local scope. Whatever you are declaring in the global, so here you are declaring a var, so it is being added as a global scope, right? So if you do the console.log foo, it will it will print value. If you just call this my function, then what it will do, it will print that foo value here. Okay. So it will print the value 10, this will print the value 11, this will print the value 10. Okay, all these things are happening because the foo is available. Foo is available inside this particular function only. Here if you just put a var foo equal to 11, then it is available inside this function. Otherwise, all the other variables are available in the global scope. Okay, function hoisting. So JavaScript in ES5, the variable also are hoisted to the top and function are also hoisted to the top definition. So because function is hoisted, so you can call the function before even defining it. So I'm defining this function here and I'm just calling this function from here. So it is allowed, right? Because this function executes and you will get the output because this function definition is hoisted to the top of the page. So your page already know that there is a my function already defined somewhere. Okay, callback is another important aspect of JavaScript, and callback is everywhere. You do the set timeout, there is a callback function for each, map, filter, reduce. All these are actually higher order function which are accepting function as an argument inside another function. So you see this for each is actually array.prototype is a for each function which is accepting another function, and I'm just doing arrow functions there. Right, so this is a best example of callback. Here this is the error callback, right? And what I'm doing here, if error is there, then it is returning true, otherwise it is returning false, right? So if you see this use callback is this is a function, and this function is passing another function as an argument. This is the callback function. Okay, if callback is there, then it is returning console.log error, otherwise it is returning console.log error success. Okay, so while calling this use callback function, I'm passing a function as an argument. So error callback, there is already a function I'm passing. Okay, based on error, if it is returning true, then you will get a success. If it is returning false, then you will get an error. So everywhere in JavaScript, it is a callback. If you write a set timeout, you are actually passing a function in a set timeout, set interval. Or you just talk about any JavaScript method, for each, a map, filter, reduce, or any error.prototype methods. All are actually, most of them are actually higher order functions which are accepting function as an argument, like all these. Promises, another enhancement on top of the callbacks, because we had a problem with the callback hell and all. So promises are the solution for that. So promises are maintaining the different state, resolved, rejected, or pending. Once you get the final state of the promise, which is either resolved or rejected, then only you will be able to execute dot then on the promise object and it will give you the result. So dot then will have a two callback function, or either you can directly do the dot catch on that. So this is the first is a success callback function, and second one is the error callback function on the promise. Okay, callback hell is whenever you are writing a one callback inside another callback. So if you see fs.read file, it is returning a callback. Here you are checking if error is there, otherwise if data is there, then another, I'm writing another code, appending the file, and then it is again a callback function. So it's like callback inside another callback. At two level, that is fine, but whenever the levels are increasing, better you should switch to the promises. Okay, thanks everyone. I will come back with another set of questions which are more on the code side, what is the output of that particular piece of code. Like there are different methods or different kind of questions can be there. Like I already have a GitHub repository, so if you guys wanted to take a look onto that, then it will be helpful for you. So crack JavaScript interview questions. This is actually interview algorithm kind of code, where like it's talking about the callback, closures, debounce, throttle, event delegation, objects, okay. And there are other questions which are based on the array and strings, like array balanced expressions, what are the common fields, common numbers in the two array, how we can remove the duplicates from an array, how we can sort it, how we can filter a particular element from the array, rotating substring, right? Checking if array is shorted or not, isomorphic, palindrome, Fibonacci, a prime number, okay? These are actually very basic questions, string reversal, or checking if string is a substring of another string, comparing two strings, checking if strings are anagram or not. All these are actually basic interview questions which you should know what all different array prototype methods we have, right? So there is a map, there is every filter, for each, index of, all these are actually array prototype methods. Then finding out the difference between two array, finding the common element from two different array, capitalizing a particular element from a string, okay. Filter a particular array, filtering a particular values from an array. Then finding out the largest from the array, finding out the two element whose sum is largest in an array, maximum occurrence of particular array, right? Merging and missing, finding a missing element from a sorted array, comparing two different objects or cloning a two different object, copying or deep cloning or shallow copy objects. All these are actually important questions, so you can just go through it, and best of luck for the interview.